1942, HMS Trinidad, a Royal Navy cruiser, was on escort duty with an Arctic convoy en route to Russia. Progress was slow and dangerous. 100-foot waves, constant darkness, and incessant and effective attacks from the Luftwaffe and U-boats posed a constant and deadly threat to the 800 men on board. Suddenly, Trinidad came under attack from three German destroyers. She was hit, but her superior 6-inch guns began to take devastating effect on the enemy ships. Trinidad fired three torpedoes, but two of them froze in the launching tubes. The third misfired and came full circle to strike Trinidad on her port side. The force of the explosion ripped a 60-foot hole in her side, decimating the Royal Marines mess deck. In the transmitting station worked 15 Royal Marines musicians, and this compartment quickly flooded with oil and water. George Lloyd frantically tried to save himself and his fellow bandsmen. He managed to take one member of the band and sprang up the narrow ladder himself before the heavy iron hatch slammed shut, sealing the fate of the 9 musicians still trapped below. 32 men perished. Trinidad underwent temporary repairs in Mamanks and attempted to make it home under her own steam. But following another devastating Luftwaffe attack on the 13th of May 1942, the order was given for for HMS Matchless to sink her with torpedoes. As Trinidad slipped beneath the waves, battle ensigns flying defiantly from her masts, she flew the signal, "I am sailing to the westward."